NGO Vumelana Advisory Fund is undertaking roadshows from this week across the country to create awareness of land reform, the future thereof, and also good governance practices. Its CEO, Peter Setou, is joining us now live in our Joburg studios. Mr. Setou, good morning, and thank you very much for coming in.
Good morning.
I just want to start with a broader question, firstly, before we get into the why are you doing the roadshows, what are you hoping to achieve, if you would allow me. A couple of weeks ago, I interviewed Professor Ruth Hall from the University of the Western Cape after AgriSA had come up with a statement to say that black people in this country now own, or previously disadvantaged people now own, 27.7% of the land. And she said they are conflating state-owned land and the hands that the land that is owned by black people. From what you've seen over the last 10 years or so, as you've been doing your work in terms of land reform, is land ownership in the black hands going up or not?
Well, Braden, I think it is important to indicate that the issue of who owns what needs to be explored quite thoroughly. So issues around audit, we need to ensure that we do proper audits so that we've got a better sense in terms of who owns what. You know. However, our observation as Vumelana Advisory Fund has been that in many instances, particularly at the point of transfer, you have your beneficiaries of land reform who do not have skills, who do not have access to market, who do not have access to finance. You know, they just get this land that's transferred to them. And that has actually led to failures in many respects, where we find that a lot of transferred land has actually become unproductive. You know. And this is where we come in as Vumelani to try and intervene in such instances, i.e. to assist these beneficiaries of land reform to mobilize investment so that we can create much needed jobs, so that we can create skills, so that we can create incomes for these poor communities.
And there were also cases in the past, the agriculture minister at some point was complaining about sometimes communities will get the land back through whatever process has been done, land restitution, and then they don't even keep it, let alone not producing on it, they then sell it. Also, so land ownership as well gets affected by that.
Absolutely. And I mean, one of our observation has been that a lot of interventions actually take place at a point when the land has already been transferred. Now, as you can imagine, when the land has already been transferred, it means the previous owners have received compensation and they have left. And frequently, you will find that in some instances, jobs have already been lost, i.e. those people who were actually employed have already lost their jobs. That is why, as Vumelana, and we are happy that lately we are seeing that that's the approach that government is also taking, i.e. to try and actually come up with interventions before the land can be transferred, so that one, we can ensure that there is continuity, we can ensure that we protect the existing jobs, so that we can even plan to create more jobs into the future.
Okay, let's come now to you. Thanks for indulging me with those first two questions, which are not really why you are here, but I just wanted to clarify from somebody like you who's been working as a non-profit organization around issues of land reform. What is the main objective of your national roadshows that you are starting on Wednesday in Pilanesberg in the Northwest Province?
Yeah. Maybe let me start off by saying Vumelana is a non-profit organization that helps beneficiaries of land reform to really work their land. We do this through funding advisory services, meaning we procure advisors who will then assist these communities to mobilize private investments. That's in a nutshell what we really do. And we also support, give them administrative support, i.e. assist them once the deals have been secured or signed between private investors on the one hand and the communities. Now, we will be embarking on a number of roadshows over the next coming couple of weeks. The first one is actually taking place in the Northwest in Pilanesberg on the 15th of this month, where we want to share our experiences with communities, you know, on what is it that we do as Vumelani, how can we work together, and also most importantly to demonstrate the value of community private partnerships. So that is the first thing. The second thing that we will actually be working on, or rather focusing on, is the whole issue around good governance amongst community CPAs. Our observation has been that a lot of times the reason why there are infightings, etc., amongst the communities who've been whose land has been restituted is largely because there's no transparency, there are no policies, basically non-compliance with simple corporate governance processes. So we will be promoting governance, as it were. Lastly, Vumelane did convene a team of about 40 people from diverse background who actually focused on coming up with scenarios around what is it that could happen to land reform by 2030. So these are diverse people who came up with finally four stories. These are just stories. These are not predictions on what would happen. Now, over the last couple of months and year, as Vumelana, we have been promoting these scenarios amongst various role players and stakeholders. Now, we've decided that we must take and promote these scenarios, take it to the communities, because these are the people who really matter within the land reform space, so that they can better be able to participate in the broader discussions around the future of land reform in this country.
I think we're going to have to touch base with you after you've concluded your workshops, your roadshows, so we can hear how they went and how these scenarios were received. Thank you very much for your time.
Thank you very much.
That's Vumelana Advisory Fund, CEO, which is an NGO that's helping with land reform across the country, Mr. Peter Setou. Now let's have a quick look at how the rand this morning is trading against some currencies, and also check out the price of some commodities.